Hi guys, welcome back to the Nik Collection series. Today we're going to talk about Viveza. Now, Viveza allows you to tinker with the colour makeup of your image in quite a detailed way. And the way that it works is that it will present something that looks like presets, only what these are is not really presets. They're amalgamations of detailed tooling such as control points and control lines that allow you to tailor the look of your photograph depending on whether it's a portrait, a landscape, so on and so forth. So these are starting points which generate effectively all the tools that you're going to need to create that style of photograph. And of course you can then move on to use the detailed tooling in order to create your own collection of control points, your own control lines, and really go to town on the colour makeup of your picture. Let's get into it. Okay, are we ready? Okay, so here we are in Lightroom, and we've got a nice file loaded. I've chosen this one deliberately because red is one of the colours that gives post-processing software the most problems. First thing I'm going to do is sort of bring this, crop this, and do the basics on the picture. We go into develop mode, here we are, do a crop. Okay, so that's fine. I don't want to go too far with this because that will impact what Viveza is able to do with the picture. So if I push this right up to the limit, which is actually there, you can see that our reds are getting overwhelmed already. So we're going to leave ourselves plenty of headroom. So, edit in. Nik 6 Viveza. Right, we're going to take the cropped copy. And we got our usual information screen about working with TIFF files. Okay, so here we are open in Viveza. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose an adjust foreground preset. Okay, and immediately you'll see that whereas before we had global adjustments and selective tones, that these are all apply equally. We've now got basic adjustments and selective tones which are applying to these control points here. Now this is a group of control points and we can see that here, that's the group, and some settings have already been applied to them, and these are, it's picked up on the color green. Not exactly what I had in mind. So what I wanted to do was to bring these up so that we're highlighting more of the stuff that I think is important in this picture. And this is really about the poppies, it's not about the stalks. So if we, having moved those, you can see that this area here is now the one that's really been pulled in. And I'll just take this one up as well, as far as that. Okay, so now we can still do our global adjustments. So we can take the brightness down. We can take the contrast down, but this is all global. And these are pretty sensitive, these controls. So use with caution. You've got structure, shadow, warmth. We've got the color red globally, which might not be a bad idea to just diffuse slightly, but it seems to, it's because this is part of an RGB curve, it's doing the red in the context of the curve. So reducing the red will also change the color of the blues because the balance of red, green and blue pixels is being changed. Similarly with the greens, okay? So what you're getting here is adjustments that are really related to an HSL setting. So these are not just the blues in the picture. This one will cool it down, warm it up. But again, less is more with these global adjustments. You've got selective tones. You can take the highlights out or increase the highlights. You've got your mids and the shadows, which we can darken down on. I quite like this real detail in the front of the picture and fading off into obscurity in the back, and that was why I chose the foreground preset. So what we've done is we've got the detail in the front, and we've got a separate layer of editing across this area here now, and we can go quite so you can see here, if I take the luminance, yeah, you can see how it's applied to these this group of control points. Same with chrominance. So the trick here is to bring that to be as diffuse as possible. So diffusion affects the way that the control point blends into the rest of it. So if we take diffusion off, you can see very clearly the area that's being affected by these control points. Here it's more subtle. And my basic adjustments here a little bit of contrast. I don't want to take the saturation down unless I can just restrict it to the reds. If we come here, we can start to play with the settings within the control points. So we can start to really get this red to really work. And what we're interested in, we don't want to lose the tone. We don't want to lose the detail in this picture. So change those highlights a little bit in the mids. But here, and that gives us, that's on, and that starts to bring a glow into the front of this picture around these poppies. And it's quite subtle, but it's nonetheless there. Now let's compare. So there's our original, there's what we've done. So I think this is an improvement in terms of what I was looking for. I could carry on doing this for ages. What I would probably want to do is to raise the luminance on here. And we're not quite perfect there, but let's just have a quick put another control point in. And let's just change the sort of that, so diffusion up to 100. And just bring that up a little bit. There we go. Okay, and that's a little bit better. Let's go back. So, and you can see this is all about adding very small adjustments and getting these tones absolutely correct. try one more here on this poppy here, and I'm going to take the just take the volume down of that a little bit, and these mirror these. So you can see that, and we're in much more subtle territory now. Give a bit more structure. Okay. And before, after, before, after. And I think just one more go on this poppy. I'm going to stick another control point in. Okay, and that one, I'm going to go brightness down, structure up, warmth, tiny little suggestion up, and red. Take that out a little bit so we get a more even spread. Okay, and that I think looks nice. So compare after, before, after, yeah. And zoom into it. I think with what we've got, I think this is pretty good. So, there. Okay, so what is this all about? So ideally, Viveza is basically an application that will concentrate exclusively on colour and tone. How this really works well, how you can really get to see the best of this, is probably combining it with colour effects in Photoshop. So what I tend to do is I will apply a color effects filter in Photoshop, and then I will build another layer on top of that with Viveza. And we're going to go into that process in a little bit more detail next time when we do the color effects video. Okay, for the moment, I think this is fine. This is as far as I want to go. I think we've seen how Viveza works. It's basically get your preset and then adjust what you find within that preset and add more detail to it. So I can apply this, and that will take me straight back to Lightroom. And there's my picture in Lightroom, or there's a version of the picture in Lightroom. And just to revisit that, that's the original. That's the version. Okay, so we've got rather more a nice sort of evening sunshine look to this with the poppies, and we've got the structure of the petals through. Okay, thanks very much for watching, guys. I hope this has been useful, and we'll see you next time.